Hey, I'm Kevin, and this is an excerpt from my most recent build in which I made a computer desk. Here, I'm specifically showing how I made this kinetic door. While it might seem complicated, it really isn't that difficult. So let me show you how I did it. The way this works is that there's three pivot points. While these two larger triangles stay still, the trapezoid and smaller triangles move outwards with the use of hinges so that the door can move. This whole thing looks pretty busy, but it's actually just a piece of half-inch plywood with a bunch of white oak pieces put on top in a mosaic pattern. The way these squares break down is that there's this large right triangle, this trapezoid here, and a small right triangle. The right angle here should be half the square, while the trapezoid and the small triangle don't necessarily have to be a specific size. What does matter though is that this square and this square are exactly the same so that the door can work properly. I have to start by cutting the horizontal and vertical lines here. That will give me two squares that I'm looking to use. But before I do that, I'm going to drill a hole where all these meet up so that the pivot point matches up for all of them. I drilled most of the way through and then I flipped it over to drill the rest. This will help prevent tear out. I'm using metal bearings for the pivots and you can see that it fits in nicely. With the hole cut, I can now cut along these lines to separate the pieces. If I were to do this again, I would probably stop right here and then cut around with a coping saw and then continue the cut so I can leave some wood for this corner so that the pivot point can have more to hold on to. At this point, I can start cutting the squares apart into the necessary pieces. I'm sure that there's other ways of doing this, but using painter's tape and CA glue, I lined up the piece on my crosscut sled with the help of a square to make the large triangle. Since I need parallel angles for the trapezoid, I can just use my table saw fence for this cut. With the large triangles, I drilled in the corners for the top and bottom bearing, and I was able to secure the bearing using some 5-minute epoxy. A note on this, make sure you have some good epoxy. I used some old stuff and the bearing ended up cracking off after some pressure. Once I used some brand new stuff, they held much stronger. The middle one is still fragile though, so be careful with that. That's why I said I would go back and cut a little extra wood for this corner so that it had something to hold on to. And here's something new that wasn't in my original video. I went back and I cut a piece on the back side so that I can have more support for this middle bearing. I wasn't comfortable with the way it was and it cracked off a couple of different times, so after adding this, I've had no issues since. Now that the pivot points are done, you just have to install the hinges. Two hinges have to be installed inwards while the other two have to be installed outwards. You can see how they are installed here so that the trapezoid and the small triangle can be lifted outwards. I used T-nuts in the corner so that I can send a bolt through the bearings and secure it to the frame. I made sure to add some CA glue to the nut so that they don't come loose over time. In the full project video, I added this mosaic pattern to the door. You don't actually have to do that. You could probably stop right there and just keep the door the way it is and it'll work just fine. But what is necessary is this one piece right here. This piece has a circular part to it that connects this door to this door. I'll show you what I mean when I get there. All right, after I cut that piece out, I was able to glue it onto the door here, and then I attach the top and the bottom together by putting a bolt through. So opens like this on a swivel. So right now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna glue on all the pieces and then we can start wrapping up this project.
There was a lot of cutting of these pieces because I had to be aware of the gaps between the shapes as well as the hinges. To account for the hinges, I used my Dremel tool to scoop away the area for the hinges to sit in. With all the pieces cut, I can go ahead and glue in all these puzzle pieces.
Never, ever touch my puzzle.
So I could get the door apart and work on cleaning up the edges, I had to cut some more of it so I can remove the hinges and it looked pretty gnarly, but I will clean that up. Because I'm working with angles, I didn't use my table saw to trim these up. I used a flush trim bit in my router to clear out the excess. I then went ahead and put a heavy chamfer where the joints will be so that they can move freely without rubbing against each other. I found this knob at the hardware store and I thought it would look really nice on this door, but the threading is too small so I thought I would try making the opening bigger. After drilling a bigger hole, I tapped the knob so that it can be threaded again. I was already thinking of different handles that I could use in case this didn't work, but actually this worked perfectly. This was a pretty good idea.
I'm a genius!
So after I clean up the bevel and the cuts in here, everything lines up a lot better. You'll see that there's a lot more space for this movement here because if it wasn't, it would have closed up on itself. One thing I do have to fix here is that this keeps wanting to rub up against each other. here. So I'm gonna put a chamfer on the underside of this. Now it's falling right now just because there's so much weight over here. When it's vertical, I think it's gonna be a lot better. The knob came in nicely and it looks nice. Good movement here. I'm just gonna make sure I fix here as well as here so that it doesn't get caught on itself. So I'm gonna take this apart one more time. I'm gonna sand down everything, put the chamfer in on the bottom, and then I can finish these doors, and this is pretty much done here.
So this is how you create a kinetic door. It's actually a lot easier than it seems. You don't have to do it exactly how I did it here. If you wanted to make a door that was just 2-to-1 ratio, you could definitely do it like that. The door has no issues with movement and I didn't have to add any magnets to it, but I do think if you had a heavier door, you might want to figure out something to keep everything in place. If you're new here, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button and turn on that bell to get a notification when a new video comes out. I make many projects like this and I have plans for many more in the future. If you like what I did here and you want to see the full project, I'll have it linked for you right up here. That's it for now. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time in the KevBot Workshop.
Oh, elbow.